Welcome to Minnetonka Cave. My name is Jared. I'm one of the tour guides up here. I'm going to tell you a little bit about some of the things that go on inside. So if you're anxious to visit the cave, you can know what to expect when you get here. Some rules that we ask you to obey before you go in the cave is we ask that you bring no food or drink inside the cave. We're trying to protect the natural beauty of the cave, keep the garbage out. We also ask you not to touch the cave. This is known as a living cave. The rocks are still growing and developing. And if you touch them, you can actually harm the rocks. We'll point out the damage you can do by touching our formations. If you are bringing camera equipment, we ask you not to bring tripods into the cave. It just is kind of small in places to pass other tours. It's inconvenient. So if you want to bring your cameras, please do. We encourage you to take pictures. There's some beautiful spots in the cave. As you can see, there are mosquitoes out here that are buzzing around, so you might want to bring some mosquito repellent. A couple other things to keep in mind if you're visiting our cave for the first time. It is 40 degrees inside the cave, and you are in the cave for about an hour to an hour and a half, depending on the tour. So it is recommended that you bring a jacket, as you are walking on some rough rocky walkways. And it is wet in places inside the cave, so you're going to want to have some good shoes on, and a jacket are the things we recommend. So you're going to go over a total of 888 stairs inside the cave. So we ask that you be in physical condition enough to be able to climb those stairs. It is first come, first serve. We don't take a lot of reservations. We do allow, if you're coming in a larger group, like a youth camp, a scout camp, or a family reunion, we do allow reservations if you call ahead. Couple other things with that in mind, we don't have a phone line up here at the cave. We're in the middle of the forest. So if you're calling the day of, we're not going to be able to accommodate a reservation because we're already up here. So it is first come, first serve. And on busy days in July, especially around the holidays, we get a lot of visitors up here. We could have 400 to 500 people through the cave in a day. You may have to wait. You may have a 2 to 3 hour wait. So it's highly recommended, especially if you have a large group and you don't have a reservation, send one person up in advance to purchase the tickets. They can purchase them for any time during the day, then go back down, bring the rest of your group up later at your reserved time, because once you purchase the ticket, that's your ticket for the day. But we can only accommodate groups of about 30 people per tour, tours every half an hour, just to, for safety's sake, inside the cave. Okay, one other thing to keep in mind, because we are out here in the middle of the forest, we can't accept credit or debit cards, cash or checks only. We just don't have the ability to process them up here. The other thing to keep in mind if you're going to come and visit our cave is we're trying to protect our bats. Bats are an important natural resource. They take care of the flying insects for us, especially the mosquitoes that have been biting me. So we try to protect our bats, and there's a bat fungus that's spreading, and we're trying to keep it from here. It's called white nose syndrome. It's a fungus that grows on the bats. It causes them to wake up during their hibernation. It irritates their skin. They wake up more often during hibernation, so they can starve to death if we spread that fungus to our cave. So to protect our bats, if you've been in a cave or a mine on the east side of the United States or in Canada, or a cave or mine in Europe, we ask that you don't wear any of the same clothing, including jewelry. Don't bring your wedding rings and your watches that you've had in those caves, because they could potentially be spreading that fungus to our cave and then obviously harm our bats. And even if that cave is 5 or 10 or 15 or 20 years ago, there is the potential that those spores could still be alive. So we ask you to not bring any of the clothing, backpacks, jewelry, cameras that you had in those caves into our cave. And while we're talking about bats, we have several different species of bats in the cave. You probably aren't going to see them on tours because they're hiding out in the cracks and crevices. And during the summertime when we're giving tours, not a lot of bats actually live in the cave. This is just a place where they like to hibernate. Going through the cave, it is exercise. I mean, 888 stairs by the time you go in and out of the cave. But it's fun, and it's definitely worth that climb, because you're going to see some things that you're not going to see anywhere else. The draperies, the flowstone are just beautiful formations. And that's one of the reasons that I love Minnetonka Cave. Each tour guide does things a little bit differently. We like to have some fun, point out the scientific things of the cave. We sure hope if you come up and see our cave that you enjoy your tour.